I mean, horizontal jaw relation, there are two types. One is centric and other is eccentric. Then in undergraduate levels, we don't record the eccentric jaw relations. We record the centric jaw relation. So horizontal jaw relation is relation of maxilla to mandible in the horizontal plane or the anterior posterior plane. So we are going to go ahead with centric jaw relation. And you should know this definition by heart because this is a very favorite question of a lot of examiners, and they will ask you, what is the definition of centric relation? And you should be able to tell this, okay? So in this definition, everything is given about this. What is centric relation? Centric relation is bone-to-bone relation. It is associated with the joint, the position of condyle in the glenoid fossa. It is irrespective of the teeth. So this is very important. This, the next question, the examiner may ask you whether it is a teeth-to-teeth relation or it's a jaw-to-jaw relation. So it's a bone-to-bone relation, okay, and it is associated with the position of the condyle into the glenoid fossa. Now, the next question may be why you record centric relation in the complete denture patient. What is the significance? Why you don't record any other position in complete denture patient? So the most, the first answer should be it is the centric relation is learnable, repeatable, and recordable position. Now, what you mean by this is patient is able to close in the same position again and again, and patient can learn this position, and you can easily record this. Another important thing about centric relation is it is a load-bearing position. Like patient can give, patient can bite hard on in this position, there will be no pain in the TMJ. So if your condyle is properly sitting into glenoid fossa into centric relation with the thinnest avascular portion of the disc, articular disc, and that position, the patient, there will be no pain on applying pressure. So this is very important thing to remember about the centric relation, and you should be able to tell this. Another important thing about centric relation is it is the starting point of all the moments. So you're going to develop occlusion for the edentulous patient based on this centric relation. That means you're going to arrange your teeth in maxillomenticus patient in this position. So in edentulous patient, the centric relation and maxillomenticus patient are going to coincide, or you're going to make this coincide. This is very important from the function point of view. So this is the significance of centric relation. And there are again a lot of methods of recording centric relation. They are classified into physiologic, functional, graphic, and radiographic. Now, the out of these, you're going to use the method which comes under physiologic classification, and we're going to see what is that method. So what you're going to do is first you're going to guide or train the patient to close into centric. Now you have recorded the vertical dimension of occlusion, the maxillary and mandibular rims are adjusted. They are evenly touching on both the sides. There is no gap when the patient is closing on them. And now you're going to train the patient to close properly into the centric relation. Now one method is the operator can guide the patient to centric relation by guiding the lower jaw, but that may be a little difficult task at the undergraduate level. So the easiest technique which actually usually followed is ask the patient to take the tongue up and back and touch on the posterior part of the palate. So in this, what is going to happen is the mandible is going to go back automatically. So with the patient, the mandible is going to go back into retroverted position, you're going to get the centric relation, automatically. So it's easy to follow. So instead of you guiding the patient to centric relation, ask the patient to touch the tongue on the palate, posterior part of the palate, and then close the jaw. And then you observe whether patient is going to close in the same position on its own without doing this also. That is also a very important thing. So you're going to see again and again where the patient is going to go into the same position on his own into the centric relation. And that centric relation you're going to record. So it is very important to train the patient first before actually recording the centric relation. Now, before you actually record the centric relation, you're going to do some markings. Now, what are these markings? The first thing is the midline. So you mark the midline first on the maxillary rim, and what is going to be the guideline? The midline is associated with the midline of the face. So if you start from the forehead, and come down and along the nasion, on the philtrum, the center of the nose here and down, and then you will get an idea where the midline is, the midline for that particular patient. So what you're going to do is easiest technique to get a correct midline is you can adapt a thread on the patient's face right from the forehead down, and you can make an indentation of the wax rim exactly following the midline of the face, and that will give you the correct midline. Another guideline which is reliable for marking the midline is the incisive papilla. Usually the center of the incisive papilla and the midline will coincide. So that is another good guideline to follow for marking the midline. Now another line to mark is the canine line. Mm-hmm. And then the high lip line. What is canine line is? It is in a line with the aisle of the nose down. So you're going to mark this, the canine line, and it's going to give you a rough estimate about what is going to be the width of the teeth from canine to canine. So all these lines are going to help you during the teeth arrangement. And there is one more line called as high lip line. So this high lip line asks the patient to smile, and the lower border of the upper lip is going to, the level of the lower border of the upper lip is going to give you the high lip line. So this high lip line is going to help you in deciding what is going to be the height of the teeth which you're going to select for this patient. So these lines are going to help you during the teeth arrangement. So when you mark this, the canine lines and high lip line, and before you actually go ahead with the centric lesion recording, you ensure that the record bases are not touching on the back. So before recording the centric lesion, it is very important that the record bases should not be touching on the back. So going ahead with the recording of the centric lesion, you're going to follow the static method, and that the name of the method is the check bite method or intraocclusal record method. For this, you're going to make a trough in the mandibular rim and nick in the notches in the maxillary. So on each side, there'll be one nick and one notch. So what is the difference between this nick and notch? The nick is half of the width of the wax rim, and the notch is the complete width of the wax rim. So why you make this like this is the notch is going to prevent the anteroposterior movement when you, after you record the centric lesion, and the notch is going to prevent the lateral movement after you record the centric lesion. So this is going to helpful in maintaining the centric lesion intact. So what you do for recording the centric lesion is you soften the wax uniformly in the hot water bath. Don't soften it over the wax. Don't soften the wax over the flame. And you're going to put excess wax, softened wax in the trough region, slightly excess wax, which will come little up the level of the trough or the wax rim. And then you're going to put this in the patient's mouth and guide the patient into centric lesion. The excess wax is going to flow into the nicks and the notches of the maxillary rim. And then you're going to get the indentation of the nick and notch on the, in the trough part on the lower wax rim. So after you record this, what you're going to remove it from the patient's mouth, and you're going to observe whether the nicks and notches are properly indented on the softened wax. So if you separate this maxillary and mandibular record basis, you're going to observe the indentation of the nick and notches on the mandibular wax rim. Now what you can do is you can verify the centric lesion. You can verify the centric lesion again. You put the maxillary rim in the patient's mouth and put the mandibular rim and guide the patient to centric lesion, and patient should go smoothly into the centric lesion. So if your centric lesion is right, it will go smoothly. These indentations will go smoothly into the nicks and notches of the maxillary rim. If there is an obstruction, that means you have not recorded the centric lesion properly. So you have to go back and again record the centric lesion. So you have to, like vertical dimension, you have to verify the centric lesion also. Now there is another important thing is about removing the rims from the patient's mouth. When you record the centric lesion in the patient's mouth and you want to take it out, what you're going to do is you're going to keep your index fingers below the border of the lower record base. Ask the patient to slowly open. What is going to do is you're going to displace the mandibular record base, and then you're going to remove the maxillary axillary cord base and take this together out. Okay, so this is very important about removing the rings from the patient's mouth. Now, after you remove this from the patient's mouth, what you're going to do is you're going to make notches on the base of the cast. These are the orientation notches before you mount on the articulator. And the other important thing is you're going to seal the record bases to the cast, and you're going to seal the maxillary mandibular back streams also together so that they don't move during mounting. Another important thing is the cast should not touch on the back posteriorly here. If the cast are touching, and it's very common observation in the undergraduate level that the students don't pay attention to the cast while mounting on the articulator, and sometimes they are touching and then go ahead with the teeth arrangement, and there's stage of drying, there is a problem, there is no proper maximum intercuspation, and then the whole thing has to be repeated again, the jaw relation stage.